This is Kurt Heisinger, accounting professor at Sierra College and author of Managerial Accounting. This video describes how to allocate costs related to joint products. So I should first start by talking about what we mean when we use the term joint products. When two or more products are produced from a single input, we have joint products. An example of this that I'll continue with in this video is if we produce different types of lumber from one tree, for example. If we have logs that we produce lumber from, then we've got to figure out all the costs that are associated with that and how to allocate those costs to the lumber that we are producing. So we're going to use the example here of grade A lumber and grade B lumber, and we'll get into that a little more in just a second. So the cost of the single input and any of the related manufacturing process costs must be allocated to each of the joint products. So again, if we have grade A and grade B lumber, we've got to take those costs and allocate them to each of those types of lumber. And the costs that we're talking about are materials, labor, and overhead costs. And I'll give you some examples on the next slide. One other important point to make before we get to that, the split-off point is the point at which the identifiable products emerge from the process. So if we have grade A lumber and grade B lumber, when does it actually become grade A lumber and grade B lumber? As soon as we can identify those two different types of lumber, we call that the split-off point. To continue with that example, here are the joint costs shown right here in these pictures that you see. So with materials, we're talking about logs. That's our input. We've got labor at the mill. The lumber mill, where we take those logs and turn them into lumber, usable lumber. We've got overhead, and overhead can be lots of different things. We just have one example here of hauling the logs around with trucks. That would be one piece of our manufacturing overhead. We'd also have machinery within our lumber mill and the factory itself, the building itself. Those would all be part of manufacturing overhead. So these are all different costs that we incur, and those costs will lead to lumber. And the definition of the split-off point is when we can actually identify those two different grades of lumber that I've been talking about, grade A lumber and grade B lumber. And that can mean, for the purposes of this example, grade A lumber could be the really high-quality lumber, and then grade B lumber could be the lower-quality lumber. So let's assume that we have $250,000 in costs with our inputs, that is, these three collectively equal $250,000. We've got to figure out then how to allocate that $250,000 to our grade A lumber and to the grade B lumber. We're going to talk about that next. There are two different ways that we can do that. The first approach that we will talk about that helps us to allocate our joint costs to the joint products is called the physical quantities method. You'll see that up here. And again, we're trying to figure out how to allocate the $250,000 in joint costs, and we're going to use the physical quantities method in this example to do that. So let's assume then that 600,000 board feet of grade A lumber is produced from those logs and the inputs that you saw in the previous slide, and 200,000 board feet of grade B lumber was produced during the month. What we're going to do then is take these percentages, 75%, which is 600,000 divided by the total of 800,000 board feet that were produced, and we're going to take 75% of our joint costs and allocate it to the grade A lumber. Then we'll do the same thing for the grade B lumber, except here we'll have a 25% proportion that we're going to allocate to the grade B lumber, because we've got 200,000 board feet of grade B lumber that was produced here, and we're going to divide that by these two collectively, the 800,000. And that's 25%. So if you look down at the bottom, you'll see the allocation of joint costs to the grade A lumber and to the grade B lumber. We're going to see for the grade A lumber, $250,000 in joint costs times 75%, and therefore $187,500 in joint costs are going to be allocated to the grade A lumber. And for the grade B lumber, we're going to take $250,000 in joint costs times 25%, and that'll give us $62,500 in joint costs that are allocated to the grade B lumber. Another approach to allocating joint costs is called the sales value method. And the sales value method will take the sales revenue from each product, in this example, grade A lumber and grade B lumber, and we'll use that information to allocate joint costs. So let's assume with this example that the sales revenue from the grade A lumber will be $240,000, that's the grade A lumber, and the sales revenue from the grade B lumber will be $60,000. What we'll do then is to take the revenue for each product divided by the total revenue, and that gives us the percentage of joint costs that will be allocated to each product. As an example, if we take $240,000 and divide it by collectively the $300,000, between that and the $600,000 added together, we would get 80%. And if we take $60,000 for the grade B lumber and divide by $300,000 in total revenue, we would get 20%. And therefore, 80%, if you look down toward the bottom here, for grade A lumber, 80% of our joint costs of the $250,000 will be allocated to the grade A lumber, and that equates to $200,000, right? And if you look at grade B, the grade B allocation, we'll take 20% times $250,000, and that means we're going to allocate $50,000 to the grade B lumber. So again, this is another way to allocate joint costs, and it's called the sales value method. We're going to compare both methods on the next slide. So what you see here is a comparison of the physical quantities method with the sales value method to allocating joint costs in the example that we just looked at. So let's start by looking at the total columns, and you'll notice that they're identical for each approach. We're looking at the revenue and the joint costs and the profit. Our revenue is $300,000 regardless of how we allocate our joint costs. It's going to be $300,000. And in fact, our total joint costs will be $250,000 regardless of how we allocate out those joint costs. And in total, we'll have profit of $50,000. However, we've got two different ways to allocate those joint costs. You will notice that the revenue is the same for each approach, right? If you look at the physical quantities approach, revenue is $240,000 for the grade A and $60,000 for the grade B. Same thing for the sales value method for allocating joint costs, because the issue is not with what the revenue numbers are. The issue is with how to allocate out those joint costs. So the difference, I pointed out the similarities, so now let's take a look at the difference. The difference then is how those joint costs are allocated. And with the physical quantities method, we allocated $87,500 to grade A lumber and $62,500 to the grade B lumber. With the sales value method, we allocated $200,000 to the grade A lumber and $50,000 to the grade B lumber. So the difference is really how those joint costs are allocated and the resulting profit then for each product or loss. And you'll see that with the physical quantities method, the grade A lumber had a profit of $52,800. The grade B lumber had a loss of $2,500. And if you go down at the bottom, the sales value method shows us that the grade A lumber has profit of $40,000, less than the first approach, the physical quantities approach, and the grade B lumber was profitable at $10,000. So these are the two different ways to allocate joint costs to products.